ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರ ಸದಾಶಿವಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರಿಯಾದಿಶಕ್ತಿಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರುಪರಂಪರಾ. ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್, ಡಿಸೈಪಲ್ಸ್, ಸಮಾಜೀಸ್, ಸತ್ಸಂಗೀಸ್, ಶ್ರೀ ಮಹನ್ಸ್ ಮಹನ್ಸ್, ಸರ್ವಜ್ಞಪೀಠ ಯಜಮಾನ್ಸ್, ತಾನೇದಾರ್ ಕೊಠಾರಿ, ವಿಸಿಟರ್ಸ್, ವ್ಯೂವರ್ಸ್, ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಟಿ ವಿ, ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಲೈವ್, ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಲೈವ್, ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಆಶ್ರಮ್ಸ್, ಸೆಂಟರ್ಸ್, ಆದೀನಮ್ಸ್, ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್, ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ನಯನ ದೀಕ್ಷ through to a video conferencing. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today I'll speak on one of my very favorite subject, puja. If I just see last 39 years of my life on the planet Earth, what is the action, activity in which I have spent maximum time? Not yoga, surely not talking to you guys and taking class, not doing sangha activity, not doing meditation. At least equivalent of the time I spent on all these activities, I spent on puja. Sometimes 11 hours or 15 hours at a stretch I'll sit and do puja. Understand, I may promote the Shaivite rituals, Agamic rituals, but I myself was Sakta. I practiced Shakta tradition, Sakta Sampradaya, means worshipping Devi. Basically, I received Bhuvaneshwari Vidya from my Guru Vipudanandapuri, after I had darshan of Devi appearing and I made the deity of Devi with my own hand in a stone variety called soapstone. In Tamil they say mavukkal. It is a kind of a soft stone. I myself made tools with my own hands and carved, took the help of local carving artisans, few hours their support. So after I did this deity, my guru was thoroughly impressed and she gave the Bhuvaneshwari Vidya and Bhuvaneshwari puja method, the practice. In those days there was no Google, so the local library is the Google. I'll go and sit in the local city library. It is not, I should not say city library, a village library. There was a government library where a lot of books will be there. And Ramanashram also used to run a library. So I used to go there and sit and download the books, download the, sorry, I used to go and sit and copy the
Pooja Pathadis available in the library. You can all see the deity I carved after having darshan of Bhuvaneshwari. Exactly as I had darshan, I carved her. And actually my life started with puja. It is Ganapati puja, Ganesha puja, with which my whole life started. If I am not doing what I am doing, I will be only doing puja. I would have been a pujari. Just sitting in some remote corner Shiva temple from morning till night, I may be just sitting and pouring water on the Shivalinga, chanting some slokas I know, or the mantras I know. That would have been my favorite time pass, or life pass, I should say. After I started preparing the manual, my guru used to correct the spelling mistakes and she will give me the meaning and procedure. Before every puja, I'll prepare elaborate manuals to instruct myself and study. Still, fortunately, we have a few manuals protected by my mother. Some of the manuals I prepared for Sri Vidya and Ramakrishna Puja and other Shodasopachara Pujas, like Sadashiva's Puja and Ganapati Puja and Durga Puja and Vishnu Puja. Still, we have some of the manuals, fortunately. Much of them are Sanskrit and Tamil mix, means in Sanskrit script also I'll write the mantra, and then Tamil script also I'll write the mantra and write the meaning in Tamil, procedures in Tamil. We do have some manuals with the Sanskrit script. Ma, can you get that? Devanagari script. Some I'll write only in Tamil, but I'll first prepare elaborately to educate myself. Thanks to my grandfather who put this seed of puja inside me, I have seen his sincerity. See, when the business hours increase, he will come back to home only night 1 o'clock. And after 1 o'clock, he will take bath and do the night puja. Night puja will be only 10-15 minutes. Then he will sing for some half an hour, all the stotras. He will go to bed by 2 o'clock. Next day, again he will be up, awake, 4 o'clock, take bath and do his pranayama. I have not seen him doing yoga, but I have seen him doing pranayama. He will do pranayama and start his puja. He is not a great pandit, but whatever few mantras he knows and stotras, with that he will do a very, very relaxed, spending lot of time, not hurry-burry, washing and cleaning those deities, clothing them and jeweling them and applying sandalwood paste and offering flowers or bay leaf and then the naivedyam. Elaborately, very relaxed way, at least 1 hour he will spend. I have seen this from the time I remember me. From the time I remember me, I used to sit with him. It's like a Skanda Mata's age itself. My mother used to put me where he does puja. So only hearing his morning puja bell, I'll open my eyes. Most of the days, his puja milk is the prasadam, first food I'll consume. Thanks to him for the sincerity about puja which he put inside me. Fortunately, it has grown, it was nourished by my other gurus, mentors, ultimately culminated into to a completion by Arunagiri Yogeshwara's blessings. He himself materialized and gave a Bhuvaneshwari Yantra and a Shivalinga and Jnananjana box. Still I have all of them. Some of the items I took it to him and he blessed and gave. Some of the items he materialized and gave. And that one activity, I should say, just I'll sit and soak myself in Bhava Samadhi. The number of hours I spent in yoga, number of hours I spent in talking to all of you, number of hours I spent in my public life, number of hours I spent in meditation, all put together cannot cross the number of hours I spent in puja. Understand, I am an intelligent man, I will not waste my time. I think this statement should make sense to all of you. Why puja? If an intelligent person like Swamiji, who doesn't waste time, has spent so much time on puja, then there is something there need to be explored. Then there is something there need to be explored. These are the few deities my grandfather gifted to me.